and pre-propose. I always have to say that slowly to Portia.
You said pre-propose. I would just say re-propose.
Whoever said that it was a pajama party? Like, did it? Right. Did that go over our heads? Did production edit that out?
Yeah.
Bob Marley? I don't get the Bob Marley.
She has locks.
Bald head, scalawag, ain't got no hair in the bag.
Welcome to my channel.
Shorty won $1 million.
Okay, so I'll probably do something like this when I get in that movie show, so that's good. And so that's why I was just like, I wanted, you know, us to feel comfortable talking. I didn't want this to feel like an interview. That's why I was like, let's get some hookah going. That's good. Let's get some wine going.
Yes.
It's wine, right? We're not drinking no champagne. Wine. It tastes like wine.
Yeah, we probably need to fix because I want it to be like a little cleavage.
Because we got the hookah going, the other call. Then this is still hitting. So after I'm probably like done talking or something, I'll probably like smoke hookah while you're talking and then chime in on anything. Okay.
Oh, wait. I need some more wine.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to my channel. Bri on TV here. And yes, I am in a different setup with a new person that I'm introducing to everyone who is watching. So she'll give her spiel. She'll introduce herself and things like that. But I do just want to let y'all know what's going on because y'all probably like, okay, Bri, we see you. You got the hookah going. You got the wine pour. Like, what are we talking about today? Tonight, on my channel, we're going to be doing a reaction video to, oh, I got to make sure I say that because I like to get details. So let me, we're going to be doing a reaction video to The Real Housewives of Atlanta's season 12, episode 11, Snake Gate episode that has everybody, oh, let's do it like together. I'm going to say shook. So 1, 2, 3, shook. For those of you who are new to my channel, thank you for tuning in. I want to say tonight's video is basically a moment for you to just pour up your wine or champagne, whichever you prefer. You know, get your hookah going if you're also into hookah, like me and my girl KeKe. And then basically just tune in with us and then comment below on some of the things that you want to discuss that we'll be talking about with this episode that literally was just like, crazy. Like, this episode was crazy. We're gonna get into all of that. Like, we gonna dissect this entire episode from beginning to when Dennis got on that one knee and pre-proposed, if that's the word, to the end where Kenya tried to hide the fact that she was wearing a wig, as if anybody did not know, boo. Like, what?
Yes.
Alright, so KeKe, let them know who you are and basically how you got into Real Housewives and why.
Yes. Hi, everyone. My name is KeKe. I've just been watching Real Housewives basically since it's aired. I actually was telling Bri that I actually went back recently. I want to say a couple months ago. And I watched the season all the way back from season one. You know, Nene is my favorite. Let me just go ahead and add that FYI. But yeah.
Do I have a favorite? I really tried to think about that before I came on here with my reaction video. Like, who is my favorite and why they're my favorite. But it's like, I want to say Portia may be my favorite because she's the most relatable. Like, she's dingy like me. You know, she slays like how I like to slay. Her physique is kind of like mine. And I feel like me and her kind of like the same type of men. Because before this whole dinner shit, Portia was definitely out here in these bookhead streets. Yes. Running around with these Africans. So I just feel like me and Portia just have a lot to like relate on. So that's why I feel like Portia may be my favorite. So the first thing that we're going to talk about on this episode of Snake Gate is the beginning.
Yes.
When Dennis decided to get on his one knee and pre-propose. I always have to say that slowly. To Portia.
You said pre-propose. I would just say re-propose.
Okay, that's why it sounded crazy. Because I'm like, I had to say it slow, but it still didn't sound right. So it's Repropose. I be sounding easy. Let it real on my channel. So what you think about that? In front of everybody. He did it in front of everybody. So I guess let him know it's real. And then we also have to talk about how he said he was selfish instead of like the real reason as to why Portia even decided to, you know, be done with him in the first place.
I just think that whole situation was just a mess. I just think that you just gotta be an evil type of person to go and have sex with someone else while your fiance, not girlfriend, not boo thing, fiance is pregnant, carrying your child.
But you know, that's actually not like unknown to like
the industry. It's not unknown, but it's just like, that just says a lot about you and your character.
And he was like, the thing that hurt Portia the most was she said it during their when they had, was it therapy or counseling?
Yes.
When they actually went to their counseling session, she was like, Dennis, like, you were all over me. Mm-hmm. So when did you have time to, like, run out here in these streets?
Because men make time for what they want to do.
I think Portia also really, really, like, truly loved Dennis. Yes. That's why she allowed, you know, herself to, like, open her arms back up to him.
I think aside from loving him, I think that she wants a family. That's something that she always mm-hmm. wanted, even from her first husband.
Yeah. And so let's talk about the lady's reaction while he was doing it. Because I want to say, like, I know Cynthia was crying. Candy was like, Candy, I think, had the best reaction. Because I think Cynthia and Eva were, like, you know, crying, or they definitely found that as a sentimental moment. You know, Nene was like, hey, I'm just here, so let me throw my little 2 cents. He got on
support,
both knees.
Support.
Yeah, she was just there to support, because all she really said was, oh, he got on both knees.
Right.
Tonight we are drinking on none other than Stella Rosa, Moscato Rosé.
Yes.
Shit. All of that. Whatever. Eva, I think, is the most shadiest on the show.
Yes.
Because Eva
throws rocks in her hands.
It's like, Eva, she's always ready to, like, have that. It's like that shade is always there.
You're right. She's already thought about it, and that's what she's been wanting to say. Period.
And I can see why Portia was actually hurt about the whole ordeal. But this is really good. Let's give, like, a toast to... Do y'all have y'all wine? I hope y'all have on wine, because we finna give a toast to tonight's reaction video.
Yes.
Okay, well. Oh, let's see if we can do a thumbnail. You don't have to smile on your thumbnail.
They do. Have you watched B-Love channel?
And but I don't want to go off of B-Love's thumbnail.
I know, but the thumbnails, they just like smile. What do you do? How do you do your thumbnail?
I give like whatever mood I'm in right now. Like, so like right now I'm not like in a smiling mood. But okay, the people, like, so gonna be shady. Like... Yeah, it's like, let me see. It's like, okay, I think I'm trying to serve. I don't know. I really can't see that far, to be honest. We can do like a fake laugh, no?
We could.
Okay, 1, 2. Yeah, because like I'm looking at you, you looking at the camera. That was actually perfect. Let's do it one more time just so that in case we didn't get that one. 1, 2. But we kind of got to be still so that way I can use it as a thumbnail.
Oh, okay. Because
we're falling.
Okay.
Okay, 1, 2.
Bruh.
Let me go ahead.
I still move.
I think my head this way is just like, I can't see my puff. Okay. 1, 2.
Bruh.
Okay. Alright. Yes, people go through all that to get a thumbnail. But now we're going to discuss when they were inside of Marlo's mansion, because that's obviously what she thought that hotel room was.
She said my house.
Her house, she had her, you know, her name bedazzled all on the little decor pieces, like... But that is Marlo, so I feel like, you know,
extra Marlo is what she is.
Like, that's just Marlo. So she was giving you Marlo, mm-hmm. and she couldn't help it. So they're all sitting down in Marlo's mansion, and they're coming up with a plan. Like, hey, we all need to be on one accord. We're all gonna say that Yvonne is the snake, and we're just gonna go with it like that. Yeah, let's basically try to figure out how they're going to confront her to get her to admit that she's a snake. Yes. Okay, so boom. That's where we're at.
And watch Portia, she cough.
Look at Marlo's face though.
But you didn't hear Portia cough when she was walking in trying to get him to hush. Like,
I missed it. She called everyone.
The fun way.
Okay.
I want to know, why did you do that to Cynthia?
Okay.
Look at Marlo's face though when she walks in.
This is a get down to the bottom of this party.
Okay, look, Eva was obviously ready to go. She was
Eva
tired.
Eva
was tired, ready to go. But no, serious question. Whoever said that it was a pajama party, like, did it?
Right.
Did that go over our heads? Did production edit that out?
Yeah. Because she was definitely said pajama party. So somebody had to say that.
Because I'm like, when was this ever said? Was it on the bus? I think, I like this look on Yvonna. I personally like this blonde hair with, you know, her showing her physique, you know, because she's really like petite and small, but she still got like, you know, some meat on her. So like slim thick. She's still like slim. She's like slim thick. And then I don't know. She's giving me like a real simple, cute, like, you know, simple digested makeup look. I don't know. It's just, it's cute. I like it.
Yeah.
I don't like the natural. When she does her natural hair, I don't like it.
Her voice just really annoys me.
I think she's trying, but she's new. She's trying to like find her,
yeah,
her, I guess herself. I don't know.
She's fine.
Candy's
fine. I want to be amongst women to tell the truth.
Okay.
I'm tired of these games. I gotta be downstairs at
5. Eva's been ready to go.
So the idea of dealing with
the fact that Eva said she had to be downstairs at 5 but was still there the whole time.
It would be somebody who knows all of us who would do something like that.
What does that have to do with me?
Because from what we are being told, it's you.
Let's also talk about how Yvonna was really like, well, because remember when they asked her, when Nene wasn't in the room, they told her like, we think that you're the one who's the snake. Mm-hmm. It's already been revealed to us.
Yeah.
And what was her response?
She just said, what does that have to do with me? She didn't say that it wasn't her. She just said, what does that have to do with me?
She just gave like this whole innocent, like, what does that have to do with me? As soon as Nene walked through that motherfucking door, it's like Nene sat down and then boom, Yo-Yo came out.
Right.
Yo-Yo was like, all right, y'all look.
Right.
This is what's about to go down. This is what we got to talk about.
It's like Nene, her bodyguard or something. Like, she was thinking that like Nene was going to save her or whatever. So.
No, I think that's what it is. So all the girls basically tried to come for Yvonna, and that's when Yo-Yo came out. And so now
Nene walked in the room.
That's when I want to say Nene intervened and was like, that's when she's starting to get her.
Yeah, that's when Candy said that, Eva said that Nene never saw the, Nene never heard. And Nene said, I never said it was recording.
No, okay, we didn't get to that part. This is Portia. Let me do Portia.
And then Kenya's like,
what's next? Kenya's like, I'm really trying to understand.
Right, I'm trying to understand what's the difference between audio and a recording.
Okay, no, let's really like talk about that. So since when has anybody ever broken down the difference between an audio and a recording? I've never heard it.
I don't know, because
it.
I think that she was trying to say is, like she said, a recording, is basically somebody had a recorder device and they trying to do some sneaky
audio. Is,
and I think that she was saying,
like,
as far as an audio, it's like
she was on somebody's
butt
voice
dialing phone, or someone else is on the phone listening, or her basically like recording it. I don't know.
Okay, so let's talk about, we're actually going to throw it back just a little bit to when Nene willingly allowed the mics to be on her when she had that conversation with Eva.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just like, how are you going to feel so personally attacked, or I don't even know the proper word, but she was just like, I guess really, really hurt, Nene, about this whole audio recording that was said about her, you know, from Cynthia. But I'm just like, you allowed yourself to be mic'd up when you and Eva were talking, and Eva was discussing her personal issues with you.
Yeah.
in Chicago, wasn't it?
Bob Marley? I don't get the Bob Marley. She has locks.
Yeah, even after Cynthia called Marlo a bitch, Marlo still didn't call her out her name.
True, no, okay,
she addressed Cynthia like, you know, you mad and all, but I thought we were sisters. Like, I never called out your name.
And I think that's because Marlo knows how to throw jabs, Cynthia doesn't. So I don't Cynthia think that, literally let herself get mad. Marlo's like,
yes,
sister, but I think her that, brownies or whatever.
Yes, but I think. Kenya is so dramatic. I do not like Kenya at all.
Why don't you like Kenya?
From the moment that Kenya got on this show, she was very disrespectful. Very, very, very disrespectful. I think that
I personally don't think Kenya like has girlfriends.
That some people really are naive about who they are as a person. Mm-hmm. A person that doesn't see anything wrong with their actions, they're just not gonna change, and there's gonna always be a justification for whatever they do. Mm-hmm. And that's who Kenya is. Kenya justifies everything. She justified the situation with Portia when Portia put her hands on her in that reunion. She provokes people. She does things to people all the time, and she likes to play victim. That's just who she is.
So one thing about this clip, though, I do like how Nene was checking Marlo.
Mm-hmm.
She actually always checks Marlo when she feels
they
like
check
Marlo.
Each other.
Yeah, like when she feels like Marlo's out of line, mm-hmm. Marlo, you know, does the same. Because I think Nene saw that, okay, this is actually getting out of hand. Mm-hmm. So Marlo, like, let me do the talking, mm-hmm. because you're taking it there for no reason.
Right.
You see Cynthia getting mad, so just boom, calm it down.
Right.
And Kenya with the, all right,
stop it, stop it.
Okay, let's keep going.
She loves to be in control.
Please, let's get the truth.
Okay. Hold her hands.
Yes, Candy. Is there audio to answer your question? There is audio.
So, okay.
Who is it, Nene? She asked you a direct question. She wants to know who it is.
Yeah,
Kenya. Kenya never. That's the thing about
Kenya. That would be mad too.
Kenya never lets Cynthia talk. She likes to be in control of everything. It's like she's Kenya's. I mean, she's Cynthia's. Like, I don't know.
Spokesperson.
Like, yes, Cynthia cannot.
What do y'all feel about them holding hands? What were they doing? They was doing this.
She asked you a direct question.
This is like the prayer. Like, we're about to pray over somebody or pray. This is like the church.
She asked you a direct question, and so she wants the answer.
I don't get this. I guess this is Kenya's, like, Cynthia, you know I'ma always have your back. Like, girl, I am here for you when nobody else is here for you.
Girl, speaking of the person who almost ruined somebody's engagement.
I know.
She will literally steal the shine from anybody. That's no friend.
To this day. I don't understand that whole part. Speak, bitch.
First
of all, you're
sitting
here judging
all of us, talking about
we think it's, etc.
Okay,
yeah. You
done got
into
a
10-year
friendship,
and
you think
gonna
see her
now?
You!
You!
Yeah.
Oh!
I felt that.
Oh! Oh, honey.
I felt that right
now. I
there.
Had to grasp my pearls, okay?
She. Let's do the shook. We was
shaking. Listen, the snake is your man.
I don't like that. I actually felt through the TV.
Ooh,
like,
that's deserved an ass whooping.
Because I mean, Portia was I guess because that was Yvonne's only like
comeback to Portia.
Comeback because Portia was like getting closer and closer with every word.
Like, listen,
so. To Yvonne's defense, that's probably what she knew it would hurt Portia when she talked about her family.
But that almost got her ass whooped, too.
It did. And I think Portia definitely would have put them paws on her.
Because Portia's a fighter.
Yvonne may be that bitch, but she definitely ain't that bitch when it came to Decatur, Atlanta, you know, Portia, East Side, West Side, wherever she from.
Yeah.
I think with her saying that, she should have been ready for whatever repercussions mm-hmm. would have came
along from her saying that, because mm-hmm. Portia was ready to risk it all. Portia's
always ready to risk it all.
Because Portia, at the end of the day, she's from that East Side Atlanta boo. Like, that shit gonna come out, you know, whenever she gets a chance mm-hmm. or whenever she feels like she's provoked to that level.
Yes.
So obviously the ladies was like, okay, this is enough because
they knew what would trigger Portia, so they all automatically jumped up when she said that.
Yeah, I think that they knew where this whole pillow talk or whatever powwow was finna go.
Yeah.
No!
And the fact that Eva jumped her pregnant ass, so Eva literally flew across the table.
I think because that would have been my reaction. Like, that was a genuine reaction. Yes, like, let me break this up. I don't care if I'm 3 months or 9 months pregnant. This is getting out of hand. Everybody stood up at this point, and that's when I was just like, shit.
Eva knew everyone knew that what would trigger Portia. So Eva flew across that table.
Especially because she's not even at, you know, she's not even at, like, the best with her man right now, so mm-hmm. it's just like, and then Portia never really told the group, because even in that little powwow that they were doing on the bus,
yeah,
I mean, everybody was still confused.
Well, no, everybody really wasn't even asking her about the cheating part. Everyone was concerned about
the animals.
And Marlo said,
"I can't bring my dog. I can't bring my dog.
Yeah."
Marla just had to throw her 10 seconds of fame in there. Like, Marla,
that's
really.
That's why I love her.
Cynthia, you bald
ass. Delaware. But Cynthia, is she bald? Like, I don't get it.
I feel like, Marlo, we don't even know her hair. Well, actually, we do know what her hair looked like when they had that natural event.
I don't remember what Cynthia hair looked like.
I don't either. I can't remember either. So.
What's she called? Bald head Scalloway.
I wanted to, because you remember that song, Bald Head Scalloway.
Ain't got no hair in the back.
Your hair is messed up.
I cannot believe this. She called her
a bald head Scalloway.
Marlo be forgetting what she, Marlo still thinks she in the hood.
Okay, so let's talk about that. So literally at this moment, everybody's true colors, where they came from, wherever they went, represent was definitely coming out.
Yes.
From Nene to...
It's the ghetto Nene.
And then Marlo was already showing her colors. Portia already, you know, whoop.
Portia's always on team.
Because with me, I'm just like, the fact that Yvonne sat there while Portia was like over her, like, yee.
Yeah.
Like, Yvonne was not ready for what was finna come for after her saying that. I think people would have respected you a lot more, yo, if you would have been like, yeah, like, I had the audio, you was dogging your friend out, so I had to let, you know.
In Nene's voice, I said what I said.
The truth, and let's just be done.
You know who it is. Just know why are you doing it?
Kenya coming to the rescue for Cynthia. Like, you don't even allow Cynthia to have the balls that people want her to have when she has the chance to have them. Because Kenya did not have to come out of that room to save Cynthia. You could have allowed...
No, I think that any time that Cynthia and Nene is together, she thinks that Nene and Cynthia are going to mend their friendship. And so she wants to stay in that spotlight with Cynthia as her best friend.
I just feel like Kenya has never had a best friend before. So the fact that she has a genuine mm-hmm. friendship with Cynthia... Mm-hmm. then, you know, that means the world to her. So she doesn't want to lose that. And so I guess she doesn't want to have to her friendship or her best friend friendship. With Nene. Mm.
Get
the motherfucking snake out the motherfucking group. So, okay, we're at the point where Nene was just about to go fucking ham.
Hey, well, I'm motherfucking Kenya ass, because Kenya does not want those hands, okay?
And, okay, so I am with Nene on this one. It's like, I'm trying to talk to my friend, mm-hmm. Cynthia, but you're not even allowing me to have a decent conversation with Cynthia and explain to Cynthia about this whole audio situation as to why we gather all the ladies in Marlo's hotel room.
Yes.
It's
my room.
Marlo, you're at home with nothing over nothing. Don't got y'all doing shit.
Marlo said, I don't got y'all doing shit.
No, that's what Marlo said.
No, that's what Nene was like, I mean, Marlo was like, hold the fuck up. I don't got y'all.
No, the way she said it, she was like, Nene was like, you got us all fighting over nothing. And Marlo said,
bitch, I don't got y'all doing shit. Marlo had nothing to do with why they were arguing.
I agree with Marlo. I ain't got y'all doing shit. Like, y'all are grown-ass women acting like y'all fucking five. Like, me and Cynthia Cynthia had a little powwow, but after that, like, y'all was amongst yourselves. All right, let me pass the hoop because I've been hogging it this whole entire reaction video. All right, y'all. Thank y'all so much for tuning in. So the name of this episode is called Snake By the Real Housewives of Atlanta, Season 12, Episode 11. I will definitely leave a link in the description box. Again, if you haven't, please subscribe to my channel, like this video, share it with any of your friends who watch Real Housewives. Definitely comment down below, and again, look out for other videos to come. I really enjoyed like this whole sit down and things like that. So this is a toast for us having a successful reaction video. Yes. Thank you. Bye, y'all. So pass the jojo, and we gon' stay ticking. Pull up that mo-mo, holla at a chicken. Shake them dread between my legs. Shake them dread between my legs. Shake them dread between my legs.